Hello and welcome to another Wargame Red Dragon video with me, Bubblebox, and today we're continuing our Bubble and Silver Dew decks series with the Anzac and Canadian decks. This time I'm playing the Anzac deck and Silver Raptor is going to be playing the Canadian deck in a 4v4, and we are joined by Nula and someone called Strahlaman. So without further ado, let's get underway. Oh, actually, let's have a look at the units first of all. I will link in the deck building videos and the decks in the description below if you want to have a look at them. I'm taking some track rapiers as my standard AA against helicopters in case I do a helicopter rush. I've got a standard kind of armored car command. And I'm bringing up some infantry in some M113A1 little machine gun toting vehicles that contain my rifle infantry, and some Aslav that contain some more infantry, and I'm bringing up 8 mortars as well. Also some S-70s containing some anti-air manpads. Now, as far as Silver Raptor and his Canadian deck is concerned, we'll have a quick look at what he's bringing out. So these nice little Wolverines, these that have the javelins on, they're really, really fast and decent anti-air units. Bringing in a couple of those, and a bunch of infantry in these little TH 49.5 trucks. Some Leopard C2 tanks, which are kind of a medium kind of tank, the best sort of tank that the Canadians have got really in their decks. Bringing in a couple of those and some reconning grizzlies, and also some fire support infantry in these little machine gun toting trucks. So we'll get underway. I'm actually going to show this in neutral today so you can see everything that goes on the map, even what the enemy are doing, because it was quite interesting, especially over in Juliet where Silver Raptor was doing a lot of battling along with Nula, and in Echo and Bravo where I was doing a lot of the battling alongside Strahlaman. Really, really interesting game, a little bit long, perhaps 49 minutes, I might speed it up in places, but very, very interesting battle. One of the opposition has got a pure Polish deck and just absolutely floods the middle with infantry. And indeed, there's a guy called Selos here, starts with a bit of a napalm strike, in fact a double napalm strike into the middle, loses one of his planes, and indeed it's going to lose the other one as Eurofighter comes in, loses one and loses the other one as well to these Patriots here of Nula's, in fact. So they they basically stopped me advancing, completely stopped me advancing into here, and that was their plan, to stop me advancing into there and then flood the place with infantry, including these little Hibernyurt trucks, which have Strela 3s attached to them. So very, very nice little trucks, very cheap as well, at only 25 points. So whole loads of infantry, commandoses, they've got some Sokols up there, MI-24, although my manpads are getting some shots off at those MI-24s. Luckily I managed to get my manpads unloaded and some infantry into the buildings and got my command into position and started firing immediately with my mortars. But the amount of stuff coming in, you can see Selos is absolutely flooding this place with lots and lots of cheap units, and takes it out on my mortars and straight away. So you've got this MI-24D that's being a pain because it's taking me some time to get my rapiers into position. They're into position now, start firing off at their choppers. The Sokols are in front, they take the brunt of the rapier fire. But I definitely need to get rid of these MI-24Ds because they are ripping through my mortars currently and putting my mortars completely out of action. I've already lost 3 mortars. The RBS-70s get some shots off, and in fact they're going to take out this MI-24D eventually, I'm sure, although it's nearly out of ammo and pretty much dead anyway. They unload all their infantry, obviously making a rush for these buildings over here. I have managed to get my SAS out, 40 of them, so they're a really decent unit, little units, and they're supported by these Aslav personnel carriers with these little machine guns as well. and the track rapier is just trying to get into some sort of position, and Strahlerman also sees that I'm in a bit of problems over here with these pushing forward and flooding center, or echo rather. He brings his Saracens in, and out of his Saracens he's dropped off a load of territorials here. He's got a British deck and some Milans to shoot across, really nicely placed units, although they have managed to get across into these trees with loads more cheap stuff. But and also Strahlerman has managed to get over here on the left to secure Alpha. Now in the meantime, Silver Raptor and Nula are kind of working together over this side. They've managed to get hold of these buildings, although the enemy have got some Gorna Strelki into the trees over here. So Silver Raptor's got this little area wrapped up. He's got these Leopard C2s in reserve here just in case he needs them, and he's just positioning his units here. So nothing too bad happening over there at the moment. All the action currently is in the middle and on just on the left here as they move their units out of here and across through towards to support Echo, bumping into these Milans and these RBSs in here that of Strahlerman. And you can see how thin I am on the ground now. My commanders have taken an absolute pounding, so have my mortars, although I have still got my mortars luckily. You'll see how much I use them later. Got some SAS in there and they have absolutely swamped this area with infantry. If you put it quickly to my perspective, you'll see that I can't really see what they've got. I haven't got really any idea just what's coming down here, but I know they've got a lot of infantry in there and I've got to try and do something about. Strahlerman again coming to support me with his Lynxes, but these BTR Zep2s will pretty sort of chew them Lynxes up if those Lynxes get too close, which they are getting quite close. I start firing now with my mortars just to try to support him with his Lynxes. And this kind of secure keeps this place under our control for a bit using the Lynx and the mortars. In the meantime, over on this side, it's all kind of like moving around. He has moved his Silver Raptor has moved his Leopards forward and managed to take them. I'm sorry I missed it, Silver Raptor. Managed to take their units out of this tree line. So we managed to control this tree line now. This was quite a hectic game. It's a big map. It's hard to cover all of it. And he's just moving his infantry. I don't think they're going to... Are they actually going to go forward? Looks like he's going to move them forward. And he's probably unaware that they've got these Conkers. They've got quite a good defense here. They've got two sets of Conkers, Motor Strelki, Manpads, and a Tunguska as well. So he's going to have to be a little bit careful there. And Nula's managed to get some Rangers right around the back, dropped off from this Chinook as well. In the meantime, we're still doing battle in the middle. Strahlerman's managed to drop off some territorials and is bringing some more units through to help me a little bit in Echo. And I'm bringing forward some more rifle infantry, more of the commandos. And I've actually brought in a couple of bush rangers as well, these really terrible choppers. I brought them in anyway. And what's that? That's that Strahlerman trying to unload his... Oh, they're Strahlerman's bush rangers actually, not mine. Okay. So he's just trying to reinforce his area here. They've got more units over the bridge. I'm having huge problems in Echo. I'm bringing in an F-111 almost out of desperation and bomb them and really don't do too well with it and lose it, in fact. Now, despite losing that, I have racked up a whole... I've killed a load of staff, but they're still flooding. And you can see they're sending more and more and more cheap units, and I am under a lot of pressure in Echo currently. I'm just glad I kept hold of these mortars and were able to use these as an SU-78 comes in and gets taken out with the help of these RBSs and the track rapiers that are now pretty much out of ammo. Now on this side, looks like Silver Raptor hasn't made the move over the bridge, which is probably, he may know there's units in here. I imagine he saw some units go into this region. So that's a bit of a standoff here currently. Neither side's got a lot of units that they can bring forward to do a big push across the river as yet. And this is a really nice defensive position for them, and also a really nice defensive position for Silver Raptor and Nula on this side as well. But not such a good defensive position for both sides is Echo, where the battle continues to rage. I have brought up, as I said, some more commandos. Still Strahlerman is trying to use his Saracens to support his territorials that are there. They're bringing in yet more units. I'm trying to use my mortars without getting them killed, continuing to micro them around as well as fire them. Track rapiers need to get some ammo, I think. Nula's just filling up his Patriots. and Stralaman is trying to take out these units from the trees over this side. So it's all a bit fast and furious. Bring in a Chinook to try and get some more anti-air missiles for my manpads and for my track rapiers. And in the meantime, Nula has actually spotted an MI4 VPK command chopper sitting on the ground right over there. And who's that saying on it? That's Nula. All right, okay, Nula's going to probably destroy that quite soon. I don't know if he's got some artillery. Oh, he's got an Attackums here. So he's firing a couple of Attackum shells. That should, well, yeah, he probably needed one, but that is going to destroy that, no problem. Doesn't even have to land near it. No, it actually landed right on top of it. So that destroyed that. So that's the command out for them. They also lost their command in India by the looks of it. So although they're doing quite well on the ground, area-wise, they've managed to get units over the bridge here. They've got some units over the bridge here. They're not really getting enough points to sustain, perhaps. I don't know. They have managed to neutralize Echo, and but they have lost quite a lot of units. I'm still killing shed loads of stuff, although not being able to push forward. I seem to kill so much stuff in this game, but never was I able to really push forward. But you'll see that coming up. I bought some Aslavs in there, supporting nicely with their little machine gun as my commandos. I'll bring in some more I think these are the SAS in these Aslavs. Yeah, the SASRs, they're a decent unit, but only in groups of two I've brought them in. So, you know, difficult. Got commandoses there. Really, really strong infantry, these commandoses I've got to try and get rid of. And you can see they've got really good anti-tank weapons. They've got good sort of machine guns. They've got good everything, basically. Really, really nice units. I've got a MiG-21MF coming in. What's it attacking? Is it attacking my command? It is indeed, and takes out my command. Gets taken out by my track rapier in response, but managed to take my command, which gives them 8 points now every round for Echo, which is a bit disappointing. In the meantime, they're still managing to keep their units in this little bridge here. Of course, Territorials aren't strong enough to go in and attack. Territorials are only really any good for defending or attacking absolutely en masse. So they're going to have to stick their whole mass of units in the middle there. And in the meantime, over on the right-hand side, Silver Raptor's brought in a couple of these nice little Bisons. He is clearly fully aware of the units in here, and he started to smoke, which makes me think he's going to make an assault, probably with these units here. The Wolverine's getting into position by the looks of it. He's got a Humvee with infantry inside. He's still got this Leopard C2 over here and a bit of recon, keeping an eye on things. Yep, he's been smoking. Now he's going to make his move across the bridge. They've put forward one of these little trucks, probably as much as anything to get a bit of recon on to see what's coming over the bridge. They're going to get destroyed, but it's a good move actually to move them out just to see what was going on. They can see that there's got some trucks coming across the bridge, and unfortunately they're kind of trying to get sight on the Conkers. Oh, the Conkers managed to take out one of his TH-49-5s, but he continues on. It's just, there's Gonostrelki in here. They're going to get shots off. Yeah, probably a bit more in there than Silver Raptor bargained for, but he's managed to unload his Canadian rifles. And with support from the TH-40, but there's a lot of fire coming in now. The smoke's not quite doing the job for them. Managed to take out one of the Conker squads. The Gornostrelki are down to 10. But probably can these guys hold on? Down to 7 now. The T-62 MV-1 moves forward to help out of the smoke. And Silver Raptor's doing his best, but there's an MT-LVB coming forward for support on the Gornostrelki now. And worst of all is this MI-24V coming around the corner is going to finish off those Canadian rifles. And the Wolverine's a bit too far back to help. There's a Humvee coming in as well with some extra infantry. Now, the Humvee did take some shots over on the MI-24V. The MI-24V very, very close. It's only firing. I don't know why its rocket pods aren't firing. It's only firing with its little minigun for some reason. Silver Raptor's unloaded his light infantry, which get taken out. Unfortunately, if this MI-24 wasn't there, they would have done a lot better, but it has really managed to support the Gornostrelki, and that little push just goes down but keeps them very busy on the right hand side. There's still no real danger of them coming across the bridge because we've got these airborne Canadian airborne there. We've got the Wolverine, but the Bisons continuing to fire in as well. Meanwhile, in the middle, the battle continues. You can see I have been pushed right back. We've got napalm coming in. I've got some Commando 90s, 40 of them. I've still got my SAS fighting away against this Gornostelki. The Commandosis are still alive, almost out of ammo. That's how good they are. They've nearly used all their ammo up and they're still alive. I try to micro my little machine gun toting trucks of death around to try and get these Pecotas out of the way, and try and I'm just moving these kind of out of harm's way, really, these RBSs, bringing forward yet more commandos in the little trucks. I've got some commandos in here, got my track rapiers there and there. These track rapiers, just I should have just brought them back a little bit just to get some resupply from that hemp, I guess. But you can see the continuous cheap units coming in to Echo. We're not that cheap. I mean, they are okay infantry, rifle infantry. They're not that cheap, actually. And meantime, on the right-hand side, electric voodoo for Silver Raptor. It looks like it's probably taken out that Tunguska that was in the trees. They've kind of spread their units out a bit now. Not sure why they're putting them in the open, but maybe it's because they were all the mortars from the Bisons. We're pissing them off. There's a Phantom 2 coming in. Is that Nula? Yeah, unfortunately gets shot down by the SU-27S. That was nice play, actually. Does manage to unleash its napalm, though, but they have actually pulled their units out to the other sides. So nice move there. Nighthawk flying around. Not sure where that went. They still haven't managed to get a command onto Kilo or India yet, though, although they have, of course, still got Echo, which is 8 points a turn. So I managed to get some more supply up just to try and buff up my units a bit. I'm almost getting pushed. Well, I've been pushed right out of these buildings. I'm just about holding onto these buildings. Luckily, my mortars are still firing away. Finally managed to get these track rapiers some rockets. But of course, again, I can't see all this. If I just put it to neutral, to my perspective briefly, I can't see what's in there apart from these front couple of buildings. But, you know, if I did know, I'd think, oh my god, how am I going to get rid of that lot? Stick it back on neutral. I think it's more interesting for this particular game. They've still got units here. They've actually got a Brom 2 over here, which I assume is... let's have a quick look. Amphibious? Yeah, it is amphibious. Now, if I were them and I had that Brom 2 there, I would have put some recon right around the back here, because that shows there's nothing here. So I would have put some recon around the back, could have maybe sniped CVs, but I didn't do that. Nula is trying, though, to get around the back. He's got his command here. They are hunting for it. Again, it keeps them busy. They've got another command over here in the Ural, which they haven't quite unloaded, and another one over here as well. That's going to get them a heap load of points, considering they've got Echo as well, if they manage to eventually unload those. In the meantime, I'm trying just to buff up my infantry a bit, because I was, at this stage, I'm running out of infantry. I've got commandos, I've got SAS, and I've got some fire support. And that, apart from recon, that's about it. So bring in my Aslavs. These have got the SAS in, and I'll unload those to try and take on these Berettis with support from these little machine gun toting trucks here. The Aslavs just pull back and try and get some sort of an angle on them as I continue to fire with the mortars. So meanwhile, over here, not a great deal happening, although it looks like Silver Raptor's bringing some units forward. It could be an assault onto India this time. Let's see if he turns in there, although they have, again, goes Gornostelki doing a nice job, and he thinks twice about it. Probably a good move. Takes out another one of his units and just pulls them right back. Those Gornostelki are doing a very good... In fact, is it Gornostelki? Or is it this Brom 2? Ah, it's this Conkers here, look, firing. Yeah, it's the Conkers from the Brom 2 firing. So, really difficult to get across these bridges. Really, really difficult. But, it's all going off still in the middle. The SASRs doing battle with a huge number of infantry. They're now pushing infantry down here. We've got a Phantom 2 coming in from Nula, is it? Who lands his napalm all over my units, unfortunately. I'm not sure what he was thinking there. I think that was a bit of a misclick, maybe, but he just drowned my units in his own napalm. What a shame. So So they're kind of trying to sneak around here. Luckily, Strahlerman has got some units in here, including these Milans, but he is getting assaulted now by Pecotas. The Territorials should do okay against them because they are already set up in buildings and there's a lot of them, but he is bringing some more units in Saracens, probably more Territorials. He's got the New Zealand SAS sitting here. They're really, really good as well. I've got some of those in my deck, which I am forced to bring out later. In the meantime, though, my SAS are struggling to hold back the sheer weight of numbers bearing down upon them, despite support from the mortars, which have now run out of ammo. Look, fired all of their 560 rounds. Crazy. Meanwhile, up on the left, they still haven't unloaded that, those Urals, look. Still haven't unloaded, and they're getting the hurry up there. So Silver Raptor, so what was that? Nudus bought in OH. Got a Lav Tua here from Silver Raptor. It's TOW 2 missiles. Probably might be going for this T-62 maybe. He's bringing up the Leopard as well. Some fire support, some AA and infantry, bringing up the other left. Looks like he's building up for another attack. And the OH is going to get shot down by those Iglas from Nula. And there's an SU-25 coming in. Going to take those OHs out, no problem. Wolverine's going to have a go at this SU-27. There's another SU-27S. The Wolverine, is it going to get some shots off? It's just not. Yes, takes it out. Very nice. In the middle, it's a kind of as you were, but they are really pushing forward. They've got tanks in now. They've got kind of fairly cheap tanks, but nothing too terrible compared to what I've got to go up against them. I brought in some Aslavs with the Bushmasters. Actually, it was to try and take on their infantry, although now they tend to find out they're up against like tanks and things. So not the best thing to go up against with a Bushmaster. In the meantime, we've got the Strahlerman on the left here with his Saracens trying to keep the enemy at bay. Still got a lot of Territorials in here. Should be able to finish off these last few Motostrelki and Pecotas. The enemy using these Poondos to good effect to pound the Territorials. Now, still got my SAS up there, still got commandos. I'm now bringing in assault pioneers because I haven't got much else left at this stage. And my area over here is under severe pressure from these Formosas. Although it says recon, these Formosas are really good infantry in their own right. Even at close quarters, they are elite as well. So nice infantry, despite, and they have actually taken out my units and moved into the buildings. I'll bring in a couple of these. Well, not fantastic bush rangers, who obviously run out of ammo really, really quickly, but kind of just slow down the enemy a bit. And in the meantime, looks like we're going to be on for a bit of an assault soon. The ranger's moving forward. I'm not sure if he's going to get these TOW-2s into range. That T-62, if it moves, they move forward, it's going to take them out because of those Arcan missiles with a decent range. Yeah, 2,800. So Nighthawk going in. What's that targeting? It's gone for the Brom 2 Conkers. Yeah. Takes them out nicely. And gets out. Phantom 2 coming in as well. From Nula. Napalm's down there. Hopefully we'll take out those Iglas. Manages to get away, I think. Yeah, nice little strike. Although it doesn't take anything out, really. Unfortunately. I could do with that Napalm over here, to be honest. So it continues in the middle. I'm getting pushed, I'm really pushed right back onto the precipice here. I do bring out my best tank, which isn't anything fantastic, a Leopard AS1+, and it does force them to pull back these little cheap units with their Strelas, which is good. I think they're after my bush rangers, to be honest. And it looks like an assault going on the right hand side now as Nula moves his rangers forward. He's also moving forward some infantry, but again, this T-62 sitting there. Yeah, they're probably not going to make it across the bridge, bringing in a few reinforcements. Nula's also, oh, Silver Raptor's got some Canadian airborne units right around the side up there. I'm not sure if they can do any damage up there unless they can get in close, but oh, there's a T-80 UM coming in on that side as well. Some pretty heavy stuff there. Now, are these guys going to attack? It looks like Nuala's going in with a Thunderbolt after that T-62 MV. There's a man pads here firing on Thunderbolt. Thunderbolt manages to take out that Evax. Is this Stingler going to get one more shot on it? Yeah, should be okay, actually, the Thunderbolt. It's taken some damage, but manages to get out nicely. As Nuala goes in with some infantry. Now that tank's gone. And looks like Silver Raptor's decided to give him a bit of support with his Leopard C2s. And also with his infantry, fire support infantry, and his little trucks. And I think he's moving forward his javelins as well. Probably need that Wolverine up. Comes an Mi-24V, just as I speak, to try to counter their push into the trees. But Nuala's managed to get some units, if he can unload them quickly before they go down. Leaving it a bit late. This Gorn Strelka will take out those units. Silver Raptor's managed to unload his light rifleman. And his little machine gun, and they take out those motor strikers. That's nice. Now he should be able to get these infantry into that tree line. And he's bringing forward his leopards across the bridge as well. And he just needs some AA. There's an SU-27 there in the background. They're just trying to get some recon. There's an Mi-8R there as well. In fact, there's two recon choppers. I don't know why they're flying two there. And they're bringing forward a lot of stuff here. Look, Meridas, Shilkas. A load of kind of medium tanks they're going to bring up into Kilo to try and push back this attack on the right-hand side here. Meanwhile, Stralaman is continuing to defend with Territorials et al. And Milan 2s. These Milan 2s are doing a fantastic job shooting across that bridge, by the way. He's also using his Harriers to great effect as well, bombing these Iglas in here. And, yeah. Just doing a decent job holding my flank there whilst I continue to try to get rid of all these infantry out of Echo. So we're quite a long way in. I am killing so much stuff here, but I just cannot push forward past this mass of units. They're now pushing forward with loads of medium tanks, and they're also pushing forward with medium tanks and a bit of a counter-attack, it looks like. Although why they're leading with Estrella, I don't know. They've got an Mi-24V there as well. Ah, there's a Hawk coming across from Nuala just to try and support this push here into the trees. But they're bringing up a lot of stuff here for a counter-attack. Got a Phantom coming in. Where's it going to hit this time? Oh, what? Is it seriously? Nuala needs to sort out, is that his aim with his Phantom 2? That's twice he's done that now. He's actually killed his own units. I'm not sure what he was doing there. I don't know if he's got full control of his Phantom 2. But anyway, in the middle, still got some commandos, some SAS in the middle, just trying to buff them up a little bit. And Stralaman's bringing in some Saracens with some more Territorials inside, but they have pushed forward their medium tanks here. I've tried to bring forward my Bush Rangers, and I've dropped off some Milan 2s just to try and keep them back. There's a Weasel flying around there. So the Territorials managed to get set down. They've taken out that Merida tank that was in the middle, and if you can just unload these Saracens, then he should, thank goodness, manage to keep control of these buildings. We've got these Milans in position there as well, one of mine and one of Stralaman's. I'm also now bringing in fire support infantry because I've pretty much run out of all my other infantry. It was an IL-102 going in for a bombing run there, gets taken out by the Eurofighter. Really nice play there. What's happening over here? Electric Voodoo trying to take out Tunguskas. Ooh, it's going to be... Yeah, it just gets taken out. But they still managed to keep their units despite the friendly fire napalm. They've still got some units in there. But for how long? They've got a T-80UM bearing down on them. Some PT-76 Desants, which are kind of little tanky kind of things. Mi-24s, T-72s, which are decent. Yeah. Guys, watch out. That's all I can say. Silver Raptor's trying to support them with these Bisons, but there's a lot of units there, and I can't see these guys holding on. We've got Pioneers, some Broken Riflemen. Yeah, I think they're out of there quite soon. Meanwhile, in the middle, the battle continues. My Assault Pioneers are in the front now. I micro my units here, these Aslavs, around to this side, because over this side they've got these medium tanks which are taking them out. So I kind of bring them around this side in the hope of getting some shots off. And Stryloman has got his territorials into position, although they've managed to get these recon units right in there, which we need to get rid of. And they have indeed, they're pushed right back into the trees. I can't, yeah, they're going to get pushed out. So they managed to get the bridgehead, and unfortunately it's been taken back again as Silver Raptor's javelins take some pot shots at the MI-24. Hopefully we'll be able to take that out. Get another shot off. Oh, a hit, but not dead. Get another shot off, surely. Oh, there's 5 more health points still. Quite strong, these MI-24s. It gets taken out that time. Excellent. Okay, so in the middle. It's a bit as you were. Oh, some more napalm going down there. Oh, I don't know. Is that a better shot? I don't know. Seems to kill a lot of my units still. And I am now getting support. Oh, actually, that was my mortars firing. I thought that was someone else supporting me. I've got some AS-90s from Stralaman, who's firing now. Actually, he's probably trying to get rid of these guys because they're actually pushing back in towards his territorials. And there's quite a lot. I've got Spetsnaz in there now, as well as the Pakotas, Motor Strelki, lots of stuff in there. He's in danger now of losing this town area over here. And over on this side, looks like that air. Oh, that Thunderbolt. Did that take out? That's taken a lot of stuff out, that Thunderbolt, this game of Nulas. I think it might have taken out that big tank, the T-80U, MU, whatever it was. Yeah, those Thunderbolts are amazing when there's no anti-air, when there's no air superiority fighters out for the enemy. So it's managed to slow down their push a little bit, but they're still obviously clearly managed to retake that tree line. So again, these two bridges proving to be a difficult place to cross. Meanwhile, the melee continues in the middle. And who's going to win? Oh, the Assault Pioneers won. Down to 1 health now. Commandos down to 3. Just 3 health now as they bring more infantry and more cheap-ish kind of, well, decent-ish kind of tanks over the bridge. I have actually brought in some Scorpion Light tanks in the hope of providing a bit of support to my infantry against their infantry. But I don't expect to come up against like medium tanks and stuff. And the Scorpion Light tanks, their armor is just not up to the job against other tanks. Basically, they're good infantry support, but against other tanks, they're going to go down really, really easily. But basically, there's not a lot else I've got to bring in, really. So Stryloman's continuing with his British deck on the over here. He's managed to push a lot of their units out. He's still doing Battle Pioneers v Spetsnaz. Spetsnaz are actually getting killed as a Harrier goes in on a bombing run and stuns the Spetsnaz, so hopefully they'll get taken out very soon. And over on this side, it's a little bit as you were. They're quite damaged. Looks like they've been bombed to hell despite their counterattack. Managed to get rid of that recon squad. I've got some more pioneers in there, so that's good. The mortars continue to fire on. Bush Rangers flying around in the background. And I'm getting support now from Silver Raptors. Got 6 of these M109A2 RCHAs out. And he's actually supporting me in the middle. That's very well needed support, as well as my Leopard AS1s are very, very close to the enemy now. Another Leopard AS1 there. I've got my little machine gun toting trucks trying to support my Assault Pioneers on the left. I've got some more Assault Pioneers going up on the left as well. Not much happening over this side right now. ADATs are shooting. That's Silver Raptors ADATs. Excellent ADATs. Oh, although straight away there's a Burattino coming in on him right into the heart of the forest. There's a Patriot in there for Nula. Wouldn't do too much damage against the Leopard 2s, but the Patriots have gone down, unfortunately. He's got a Leopard C2 here that will survive with its Coyote reconnaissance. And they start a push across the bridge on the right-hand side with T-55 AMVs. So he's got a cavalry tank here, which I'm not sure if it will hold those T-55s. Looks like his ATGM. Oh, there's the LAV AT there. If that can get some shots off, it might take out these T-55s. Can it take one out? Ah, it misses. If it misses, it's going to get taken out itself because its armour isn't fantastic. There, arm there, misses. Oh, Nighthawk goes in. Beautiful. Oh, nice. Now this LAV anti-tank or this cavalry should be able to finish off that T-55 there and stop that little push. Oh, I've got his Leopard 5 C2s firing across as well. Takes that out nicely. There's a PT-85 in the water. Surely that Leopard 5 can take that out. If it ever reloads. It's stunned, of course. Takes a lot longer to reload. I'm not sure where this truck's going here. And this TUA. Where's that going? Just don't seem to be able to finish off this PT-85 in the water. We'll come back to that anyway. See if it's dead in a minute. In the meantime, in the middle, the mortars continue to fire as they have been firing the whole game. Still loads of infantry to clear. Got our assault pioneers on the job. They are firing their flames, which is good. They have to get really close. The range on those is really short, but they're doing a good job against those Berettis. Now they're bringing an Mi-24D right on the correct side to try. Although they're getting very, very close. They're getting much too close, in fact, and the RBSs are going to get shots off on them. As well as the Stormers back here as well. Take them out. This Mi-24W is getting way too close and gets taken out as well. Which means my assault pioneers can continue in their good work. Got nice control over here now. They're looking a little bit thinner on the ground than they were initially, although they are again bringing in more and more units down the road. Got some MiG-21 MFs coming in with their rockets. And what are they aiming for? My assault pioneers. Yeah, nice. Stunned them completely. Got another truck rapier coming in. What's this? Silver Raptors Centurions. Don't know where they're going, actually. He's still supporting me with his artillery, which is excellent. And the enemy are trying to push across with some Gorna Strelki this time as Nula kind of counterattacks. There's a Chimera there. Silver Raptors put a Chimera in the trees, which is a good move. Really solid anti-tank weapon. Although it can fire against infantry as well, of course. Really a moving gun. No strutting turret, of course. But that can sit there, really well armoured, and stop them pushing across there with any heavy armour. And they're attacking on this side as well. Got three T-80 BVs. He's got his Highlanders sitting here with their Eric. So if they come too close, hopefully they'll be able to take them out. Got an ADATS also firing on them. Hopefully we can get rid of one or two of them with the ADATS before they run out of ammo. Got one shot left. Gets a hit. One's gone down. Got one more shot, actually. Gets another hit and forces him to pull back, which is good. But he brings forward his Mi-24Vs now. Nighthawk's going in for a bombing run. Where's it going? Into these trees against these Desants. Yep, takes them out nicely. Gets himself away. Got some MiG-21S coming in yet again with their little rockets. I wonder where they're going. I bet they're going to come sweep right round and attack the infantry in Echo. Just have a look, see what they do. Yeah, they're coming round. Now, what have we got? We've got track rapier on this side. Dropping. Can we take them out? They've dropped a lot of ordnance. One's down. Track rapier's firing away. Takes another one and the other one. Yeah, good. So we've got track rapiers nicely spread around. I've got a couple here. And then there's Stralaman with his track rapier FSA. Yeah, managed to take them out. They didn't do too much damage, just got my New Zealand SAS back into that building. I'm now down to my recon, but these New Zealand SAS actually proved to be a really, really nice unit. They are recon units, but they're also assault units in their own right. They are elite, and they have close quarters combat machine guns, so I decided to move them forward, in fact. Okay. And I do eventually bring some more in, I think. Now, we're getting really low on supply at this stage. We've used all our fobs up, and or almost used all our fobs up. And there's empty logistics trucks scattered all over the place. You can see the enemy haven't used quite so much logistics up because they tend to sort of just throw more cheap units at us rather than resupplying their better units, if you see what I mean. They've still got a bit of a beachhead here. Well, I say a beachhead, just some units and some trees. There's then Stryloman's managed to almost push them out. He's got these centurions. Is that Stryloman? Oh, it's Silver Raptor. He's over this side with the centurions. Okay. Managing to push the Spetsnaz out of these trees for sure with those two centurions. Centurions are really not the best in the world, but against Spetsnaz, they'll should be able to take them out. They've got okay armor with 9 front. For, I mean, for only 25 points, what do you expect? They're decent just for playing through trees, clearing out Spetsnaz. Yeah. MiG-29 coming in there. What's that attacking? I'm not sure. It's attacking nothing. It's flying right over our unit. That is going to go down. Where's it going? Yeah, complete. I think he just completely forgot about that. There's another Attackum's going in there. Takes out, what? A Ural. Another Attackum shell. Is he going to get this Desant or the Tunguska maybe, or maybe both? Gets the Tunguska, very nice. Chimera is still sitting there, ominously waiting for the enemy to cross the bridge. Another, there's our Adats refueled. Meanwhile, my New Zealand SAS have crept themselves forward a little bit. I've got some salt piners in there, I just want to buff them up as well. Of course, I still don't know. Ooh, there's an ATGM there. Still don't know what's in there completely. If I put it quickly to my perspective, you can see I can't see the enemy, just these ones out the back. Can't see any of the enemy in the buildings, and I'm still mortaring where I do see their do see the enemy. There's not that many infantry left in here now. I've got 45 Berettis, 25 Berettis there, and 11 other infantry there. So yeah, once these are buffed up, push forward, hopefully we'll be able to take them out. I can't even remember what happened, to be honest. Now, they are pushing down the left-hand side now. I think they've probably left it a little bit late, maybe. There's 10 minutes left. But they've been spotted by Silver Raptor. So hopefully something will be done about those. And Silver Raptor actually brings out some Leopard C2s on the left-hand side. So Silver Raptor's kind of put a bit of a defense here, leaving Nuala to attack up here now. And he's kind of supporting over the board, keeping an eye on everything. Which is good. So he's still supporting me with his artillery here. As they push forward with their remainder of their infantry that they've got in Echo, bump into our assault pioneers and our New Zealand SAS. I just wish Stryloman had just brought those territorials forward as well to help out a little bit, but I guess he was very busy elsewhere. Although he's got quite good control over here now. Looks like he's got control. I think he's more preoccupied with what's going on over on the left-hand side here. So it looks like there's a push on the right-hand side, and it's Nuala with heavy hogs. Nuala's spammed out some heavy hogs now. And he's just pushing forward, takes out those conkers, and continues on his way forward. And Silver Raptor's seen this as an opportunity to get over the bridge with his Wolverine, his Chimera, and his Leopard C2. And Nuala's bringing in some recon in a Chinook. And Silver Raptor's moving forward his Adats as well, and another Adats over here. So this heavy hogs have all gone down. Oh, the Burattino there. Just doesn't... Got some units down there. There's the... I don't think you can see the command, unfortunately. But the Wolverine's taken out a helicopter. The Chimera's going to get into the trees. This Chinook should be out one load. We've got a Leopard C2 from Silver Raptor. A bit of supply and an Adats. And if this other Adats and the two are managed to get across, there'll be a nice little bunch of units back in the trees yet again. There's an Osa coming across there, but that Chinook just needs to watch out for that. Just needs to land really, really quickly. Chimera's taken it out. Beautiful. So that Chimera's in a prime position now to stop anything coming down this road or across this open ground. Bringing the Wolverine to support it and the Leopard C2 just to cover this open ground here. And we get a bit of recon from the Chinook and a bit of supply. So that's excellent. And the Adats coming up as well to support. Meanwhile, I'm bringing in my Carhus. As you can just see there, the Carhus, I really like them. They'll take out, they'll fire their missiles all day long and try to take out lightly armoured vehicles or even heavier sort of medium tanks and stuff as well. Even heavy tanks, they can do heavy tanks decent damage as well. So they're still pushing through on the right hand side here. I wish they'd done this earlier, or they should have really done this earlier. But Strahlerman's dealing with it. He's got Toe 2s out, he's bombing with his Harriers, he's got some Track Rapers coming across in case they've got any choppers or bring any planes in to attack these tanks and stuff. So that's kind of under control over there. And in the middle, we continue. Wow, Track Rapier shooting at something. Oh, they're bringing some choppers, some Mi-24Ds they're bringing in now, and some Janowskis as well. These have got Strelas and anti-tank weapons. Not the most accurate thing in the world, but decent still. Still decent. I've got my RBSs firing at them, though. Take them out nicely. Oh, they weren't mine, were they? Oh, yeah, they were mine. That's good. I'm not sure what these Unimogs can do, apart from soak up the enemy ammunition. So these Desants are going to get taken out by the Milans. Two sets of Milans sitting there. Territorials behind. Don't know what that Mancati 6x6 is doing there, really. The artillery, my mortars, I've only got two left now. I don't know what happened to... Oh, no, they're here, actually. The five mortars are there, completely out of ammo. Bringing another Chinook in, because we're completely out of ammo everywhere, pretty much. It's just what you can bring in off board now. So they've secured this tree line now. It's been going to and fro the whole game. They are sending forward some motor Strelke, but these Chimeras will absolutely decimate those Gorn Strelke, surely. They're trying it with planes now. I think they've kind of given up on the infantry at last. They're getting wiped out over this side. Silver Raptor's got his two Leopard C2s over there as well. It's an Electric Voodoo. Is that Silver Raptor? Yeah, Silver Raptor's Electric Voodoo. Trying to take out... Those, oh, I don't know if that got out or not. Don't think it did. There's an SU-27S coming in as well. So watch out, that Harrier. Watch out, Harrier. Evac. Gonna get one up the ass. Boom. No, I think it managed to get out. She needs to evac it, really. That SU-27S coming around for another run. It's gonna go down, isn't it? He's just forgotten about it. Oh, it takes another hit, but survives. Oh, it's a VAC bingoed. Okay, good. So did that Chimera? Yeah, that Chimera must have taken out those Gornostrelke. Oh, the Gornostrelke have gone into that building. Sends forward a little truck just to see what's there. There's a lot of stuff there. They are kind of... Oh, some artillery coming in there. Very nice. Stunts everything. Not really got enough to push forward into this region, but certainly with that Chimera there, unless they send in a... Wow, that Burattino is well damaged. Look at that spread. Still stunning Silver Raptor's units. But that Chimera, the only thing that's going to really take that out is not a chopper, because you've got your Wolverine and the AT-ATs. Just an anti-tank plane might take it out, but I'm not sure that they've got anything left in their deck powerful enough to take that out. However, there's a Brom 2 coming up the road with BTR. Very, very damaged, though. T-72As, if they get really close, they could do damage. AT-ATs are firing off. AT-ATs not well armoured, so they need to fire really fast. Otherwise, they're going to get sort of overwhelmed. The Chimera, although it's powerful, isn't that fast firing and gets taken out. As I said, the T-72s, because they got so close, were able to do that. What a shame. And they are now counter-attacking into the forest yet again. Leopard C2, the Wolverine's pulled back, Leopard C2 left, the Chinook's doing circles up there, completely out of control. Pulls back the Leopard C2, these T-72s are very, very dangerous up close. The KE rounds, yeah, took it out. And that Wolverine's going to go down, and they are actually going to retake the trees. I never thought they'd do it, especially with the units they attack with, but they've managed it. This BTR will take that chopper out, as it has done. The T-72A will take those Wolverines out as well. So they regain that yet again, and they're doing a big push over on the middle here. T-80UM. We've got the Highlanders here with their Erics. Unfortunately, they're just out of range. But got T-72, oh, lots of heavy tanks. Tunguska coming over as well. got a robot coming through here. We've got light riflemen, we've got Highlanders. We've got the Lav Chewer, which can chew up that T-80U. Pulling back the Patriot, which is good. We've managed to get some Spetsnaz in over here somehow as well. So a big push by them in the middle there. And in my middle, I'm still doing battle with these guys. They're bringing forward a load of choppers now. I did bring forward some tanks, some light tanks. I thought I'd just try and go across and wipe out their infantry. But they brought in these Mi-24Ds. Now, I did have one track rapier, which I managed to micro forward while I was microing back the light tanks. And did a great job just of pushing their... have we got one more shot? Yeah, took out another chopper, and then that's out of there. Unfortunately, didn't quite have enough bullets to or rockets to finish off the job. I've got an S-70 with some manpads in just to land and take care of any choppers that come across there. And the Milan 2s of Stralaman firing on the fresh reinforcements from the enemy as the New Zealand SAS continue to gradually creep forward. In the meantime, the big push over here, they've kind of got everything into the trees here. The Wolverine survived. Look, the T-72 doesn't know it's there. But they've kind of got everything into the trees, but they've not pushed on any further. And the artillery is going to come in on those trees, as it's doing right now. And if they push this way, you've got the Highlanders sitting in the way. These robots are going to get taken out by these riflemen. And we've got ADATs and Tuas over here. And the Tuas are in fact firing and take out one unit there. Kaihu's still flying around trying to do the business. The left-hand side has been almost kind of secured now. They're not going to be able to bring anything else over the river there. And Struliman's got, yeah, a really nice line of defence all the way along the river. And back in Echo, the mortars continue to fire in on the enemy as I just try to push forward with my New Zealand SAS. Time's running out though, just 28, 27, 26 seconds left. But it's been a good battle in the middle for Echo, really enjoyable. And over on the right-hand side, it's been interesting watching out the to and fro across the river. I've never seen so many battles go to and from across the river before. I do send in a napalm bomber right at the end there. I didn't bring it in earlier. They've got no ACM, bound to lose it. It does go down, but I managed to just napalm their units right at the end there as the game ends. 50-minute game, really nice game, really enjoyable. Nuala Lossum did well because he got a negative kill loss, but he used some heavy point ear planes and stuff, so I think that was the reason. But he really helped in the game as well. So thanks to the enemy as well for doing such a great job with all that spamming infantry. It was a really fun game to play. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. Looking at, again, we didn't have the best decks because we were playing the Anzacs and the, remember, we were playing the Anzacs and the Canadians. And we definitely needed Nuala and Stralaman support. Although Stralaman had, of course, a national deck with the Brits as well. So good game all round. I'd like to thank you very much for watching. Check out the decks if you want to. The links will be in the description. And yeah, I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.